They are the $3.5 million eyebrows. That is how much Cara Delevingne's modelling career is estimated to be worth. She was scouted at just the age of 10 years old. She's walked catwalks for every brand, from Chanel to Victoria's Secret, Topshop to Tom Ford. She was 2013's most Googled fashion figure and most reblogged on Tumblr. She's been on the front cover of Vogue. And then she pulled the plug on it all. As of last week, Cara Delevingne is no longer represented by her modelling agent, and it's all so she can fulfil her childhood goal of acting. Paper Towns is her first headlining film. It's out this Thursday, and it's one of five Cara Delevingne movies coming out in 2015 alone as she makes her big shift.
Was there a moment when you realised that you actually had to take control? You couldn't just kind of continue doing what you were doing?
Yeah, there were a couple of moments, probably. It took a while, I think, to really get into my head that I had to change something. And it was a slow process of change, too. You can't just suddenly be like, hold on, these are my reins.
We've gotten off to a good start, haven't we?
No, we have indeed, yeah.
I'm a supermodel. What? No, I'm not.
I have a female version of a boner. What's it called?
I don't know. I was young and... I liked people telling me what I needed to do all the time, and it was easy because I then could do what I wanted otherwise. It's hard because models are kind of seen for just their outer, what they look like. So it's kind of hard to get people to respect them as people sometimes. And it's not. There's just like certain occasions where you're just kind of treated like cattle. There's just like stuff like that.
If you're not aware with what's going on in your body, no one else will be. Once a month, you need to cup them, really grab them and give them a good squeeze, give them proper inspection.
Well done. Well done, Mag.
Now that you've stepped away from the modelling world and you've got a string of films coming out, you've got a bit of distance from it. Is there something you would like to change about the way the fashion world treats models?
Yeah, it's more, I think, for people, younger girls. It's getting younger and younger, and it's just, it's hard because there are so many models, so they kind of just kind of pick you up, squeeze you, and then push you away, and that's kind of what they want. Models don't have a long, kind of lasting thing. So I think once you get to a certain age, if you haven't taken control of your own, career, I guess it's not the fashion world's fault. It's your responsibility to do that, but I feel you need to be in control.
Yeah. There's gonna come a time in your life where you're gonna think, what do I regret more? Removing Chuck's eyebrow or not removing Chuck's eyebrow?
I get it. What the?
Look at us, we're ninjas!
You're a ninja, I'm not a ninja.
So, after seeing this film, Paper Towns, nobody's ever going to call you model turn actress anymore. They're just going to call you an actress. And it's kind of really fun to watch that.
I'm not joking. Please. That's all I want in the world, so that's really nice. Oh, no, I didn't mean to.
How long have you harbored that? Because I read something saying you wanted an acting agent when you were like, is it 10 for your 10th birthday?
Probably around 10, yeah, 10, 13.
How does that conversation with mum and dad go? Because most kids aren't asking for that stuff at that
age.
Are
they not?
No.
Really?
No.
I don't know, I just was. I don't know, I literally felt like I came out of the womb wanting to act and do music. So I was doing plays since I was really young, and then I loved watching films, still performing. And then I was like, well, how else do I do that? I need an agent. Guys, come on, help me out. They were like, no, you have to finish school. Mean.
Bastards. How dare they?
Thank you. Well done. They did well.
Stop. Don't.
It's really loud.
Don't. Paper Towns is, of course, your first big starring role, but I was fascinated to discover that there was a chance earlier on that you might have been Alice in Wonderland as well. Tell me a little bit about how that kind of transpired.
I was still at school. I went to a very artsy school, and they sent just a sheet basically saying, just with a couple of words on it and saying, however you want to do it, film it yourself with a video camera. So it wasn't really a script, it was just kind of a poem that you were meant to do by yourself, and I made it into this very strange, schizophrenic, crazy person doing it. And I guess they really liked it. And then, like, a couple of months later, I was in his house and, like, meeting Tim Burton and kind of being like, oh my God, I'm 16, what am I doing here? This is so weird.
So in that scenario, what's your pitch? You're like, I'm Cara, what do I do?
Oh no, I wasn't. You don't pitch yourself on those things. I mean, it was just, especially since I was at school, I very much took it seriously and was just always in character and being weird.
I want to assemble a task force of the most dangerous people on the planet who I think can do some good.
Of course, after Paper Towns, you have the mega blockbuster of Suicide Squad coming out. And I read a story, and feel free to correct me if this is entirely wrong, but is it true that they have an on-set psychiatrist in case you become too villainous?
I can't tell you.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Shh. You read that?
Yeah. Adam Beach is out there telling it on red carpets.
He is?
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to get in trouble.
Okay,
already in trouble. I don't want to get in trouble.
Don't get yourself in trouble. Cara Delevingne, it's been an absolute pleasure to meet you.
Thank you so much. Pleasure.